This is Kaimosi Forest. A study of the list of mammals, trees, and mosquitoes indicates that the relic forest of Kaimosi contains numerous Western species not found elsewhere so far to the east. A forest that was once teeming with indigenous trees and wildlife is slowly becoming decimated by local communities. From afar, it looks like a forest, but once you come closer, the evidence becomes clearer. Pressure from human activities involving logging and excavation of gravel for road construction are to blame. What you are looking at here is a deep gully that was formed by rainwater, which causes havoc downstream. Patrick is a volunteer forest guard, and as he explains, poor management by the Friends Quaker Church Mission, which has isolated the local community, is partly responsible for the forest destruction.
Poor management.
Eleza kidogo.
Sasa manyo mulirugo. Mundo alini chaji Kaimosi. Akutupa peke yake zindani anakula peke yake kwa msitu. So that's why at the community wanafika mahali wanaona. Yeye nao waanze kufanya nini? Kuikatakata so that pia nao wafaidike na.
Ana mismanage aje huyo mwenye hapa anashikilia msitu.
Eh?
Mundo alienda mtu kwa nuku akumani akumani.
Alienda mission nini? Ani hapo kwa zakoni kwe kwe. Asa ni individual.
Sina cha khoramu.
Eh?
Sina cha khoramu.
Sasa kama ni miti yesi kama yeye anakata atamache je aje niba ni kwa harono kukulita kulitira bandu. And change she mission. And kha bandu bose banyanya mu. Mhm. Kwa 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 ro manya. I job ni vula kuli ma youth manya baka. Yeri vita bareme banyore tsho yitu batiba kulitira banyore. Kuli banyala maisha ka ka kawida.
What can be done to salvage the resource? Patrick proposes co-management that involves partnering with the Kenya Forest Service Guards, the Friends Quaker Church, and local communities. Makuchi Youth Link Group was formed in the year 2010 to help with environmental education. With funding from the World Bank and the United States Agency for International Development, they have managed to introduce indigenous tree seedlings and income-generating activities for the youth in the communities. Over 20,000 seedlings have been distributed so far. We also have a school program where students compete writing essays and stories about environmental awareness. They are now aware that the forest plays a crucial role in our climate change and precipitation cycle. Ronald grew up around Kaimosi Forest. His grandfather was a local medicine man who knew the forest in and out. He used to treat people with herbs and honey collected from the forest. During those days, people valued the forest as a sacred grove. However, Ronald worries that the loss of such indigenous knowledge is a major reason that contributes to the destruction of the forest by the current generations. But as Ronald explains, a lot of animals have been hunted illegally and trees felled indiscriminately. Human wildlife conflicts have also become common. Ronald is worried that some of the medicine trees have been lost this way. Mama Rose is a good storyteller who uses indigenous knowledge to educate her audience. She has worked with a lot of women groups as a grassroots organizer and understands Kaimosi Forest well.
But tinyasi kadi bandu bali bayaza kugenda shikira kotsa mukulola rola manyonyi mu rola tinya makuru tsikenda mu kadi bandu bayanza mushikira bunna nichije chekalaha yatsa mweno mushikira yenya bandu bomuloleta.
According to Mama Rose, traditional knowledge and specifically taboos were the basis of sustainable use and protection of Kaimosi Forest. The same applied to collecting firewood. Mama Rose understands clearly how this has impacted the climate change in the area. Prolonged drought during planting season has reduced food harvest significantly, hence frequent food insecurity in the area. The value of traditional knowledge needs to be emphasized to school children and the youth in the community. And that is our crusade. To help save Kaimosi Forest through environmental education in the community, one story at a time.